Sometimes you just have no idea what life has in store for you. It is a great honor and privilege for me to stand here before you tonight representing the Kay Yow Cancer Fund, and such a humbling and tremendous experience to work alongside of Kay Yow for 15 years, right here on this court behind us. It's amazing that it's already been 10 years since we started the Kay Yow Cancer Fund. It's incredible. Of course, so many of you have said to me tonight, like, gosh, I wish Kay was here. I wish you could see this. I just wish you could be a part and see all the wonderful things that have happened, that the fund, the impact the fund has had, to see our very dear partners sitting here, and all of you who are KL people, supporters, and just have continued to help the fund achieve a major impact in the fight against all women's cancers. So when Coach Yow thought about what to name the fund, she wanted to do something that would unite a nation of coaches and players and fans of women's basketball. That's really how she saw it at the very core. She also knew that we could talk to businesses and corporations and get them involved. We actually had to talk her to put her name on the fund, because as you know, Coach Yow, she's very humble, and so she wanted to call it the Coaches Fund or something like that. And so we talked with her, talked to her to put her name on it, and she had such a vision for it. And she often talked to many of us that are here tonight about how we could just raise $5 million a year. And of course, that seems so simple to Coach Yow. Just go out, you know, have a game and raise $5 million. And if this many schools raise $1,000, this is what you'd have. And so here we are trying to execute her original game plan still. And it's an honor to be able to do that. You knew Coach Yow, and you knew that she was a woman who lived her life giving to others. Every day, she walked the walk. Every day, she lived with the servant's heart. She served others. She was about others. And so it's so appropriate that in her death, part of her legacy is the Kay Yow Cancer Fund that continues giving to others. So it's pretty amazing what has happened. Tonight, we're so excited to honor the V Foundation, the WBCA, Nike, and ESPN, as well as the all-time leading fundraiser in the National Play for K initiative, which is NC State University. And then a very special person that I'll speak about in just a second. So I want to say to Nike, ESPN, the Foundation, WBCA, what you'll soon find out is all of these people had very personal conversations with Kay. They heard her vision, they talked with her, they encouraged her, they advised her, they rallied with her, and we are so grateful to all of you, because the Kay Yow Cancer Fund wouldn't be where it is today without these partnerships, and many more partnerships that have developed over the years, here locally, nationally, and then for the many donors that have contributed money to the Kay Yow Cancer Fund. Because of all of you in this room, in 10 years, the Kay Yow Cancer Fund has given $5.63 million in the fight against all women's cancers. Thank you. So, as we said, Coach Yow had a game plan. It was simple to her. She was quite sure we could immediately get to $5 million a year in support of all women's cancers. We're still working toward that goal, and it's a very realistic goal, and we will continue to need all of your help and the help of our continued partnerships here that we're going to honor tonight. So, it takes me into the latter part of Coach Yow's life. She really wanted to ensure that a number of things were taken care of, and one of those, of course, was the Kay Yow Cancer Fund. And what ended up being probably just about 3 weeks before she passed away, Marsha Sharp, who is a legendary women's basketball coach at Texas Tech University, won a national championship, Coach Cheryl Swoop, she's in the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame, and many other halls of fame. And in Lubbock, Texas, there is even the Marsha Sharp Freeway. So, yes, that gives you an idea of this person. And so I think that, not to steal Marsha's story at all, but I think she and Kay have been longtime professional colleagues and friends, and really the two of them with many other women really drove the sport forward. And so when the Kay Yow Cancer Fund was established, Marsha Sharp from Lubbock, Texas, just jumped on board immediately. And she went from saying to Kay, yes, I'll be a board member. And then she went to, okay, I'll be the president of the board. And Kay, let's run a golf tournament in Dallas. It's our first one. Marsha spearheaded that, got all these LPGA players to come and coaches across the country. She's now a lifetime board member. But Marsha was willing to step up and step in a big way and serve as the Kay Yow Cancer Fund's first executive director. And that took a lot of courage. It took a lot of passion. And it took a great vision to step into a seat for a national organization that had just been rolled out. We were, the B Foundation and the WBCA were gracious enough to help us collect the donations that came in to begin with. We didn't even really, it didn't have a website. And we started really in that way. And Marsha became our leader and was a tremendous face for the fund nationally. Among the coaches where Kay saw the entire thing at the beginning. And so it's only fitting that we're going to give our first Kay Yow Cancer Fund Impact Award to Marsha Sharp. Hold on just a second, because I want to reach the criteria that we came up with. The Kay Yow Cancer Fund is establishing an Impact Award to be given to an individual or organization exemplifying Coach Yow's spirit, reflecting her resolve, grace, generosity, and servant's heart. Coach Yow was the epitome of courage and strength in the face of great adversity. Her response was always to give to others. There is no better example than while battling stage 4 cancer, Coach Yow gave her greatest gift, the Kay Yow Cancer Fund. In that same spirit, this Impact Award will be presented in recognition of making a significant impact in the fight against cancer, improving lives, and giving hope. And so I want you to join me in the very warmest welcome possible. Marsha Sharp is our first.
Well, thank you so much, Steph. I'm really honored to be here tonight. I will tell you that the first time I knew about this award and this evening, the first thing that went through my mind was, there are so many other people who deserve to have this. I could go all along this front row for sure, but there were five of us who are lifetime board members of the Kay Yow Cancer Fund. Stephanie's one of those. Connie Newcomb, Norlin Finch, Debbie Antonelli, and I. And they have become my incredibly good friends through this. And I think there have been days when we really scratched our heads and tried to decide which grenade to jump on next. And then some days we were so thrilled with the results of what was going on. But those guys, and another one that came to my mind as soon as I knew about the award was Sherry Cohn, who's the head coach of the University of Oklahoma, and the work that she's done as the president of the WBCA in regards to the Kay Yow Fund, and now as the president of this organization. She's been unbelievable. So, you know, you guys, I know that it makes the award much more special to me tonight, because I know what you've done, and I'm just so honored to receive it. I retired from coaching at Texas Tech in 2006, and the calls that Stephanie was talking about came to me in 2007 from Kay. One, to see if I would be on the board, which I immediately accepted. The second one, to ask me to be president of the board, which took me a couple more minutes, and then I accepted. And we rocked along through that first year with some different events, the golf tournament being one of those. The fund was beginning to grow. There were things that were happening. People were catching on more. Games that had a lot of pink involved were beginning to be played, and we were so thrilled about all of that. At the same time, Kay began to lose ground a little bit during that period of time. So in 2009, right after the first of the year, I received a telephone call from Steph. And she said, Marsha, Kay would like for you to come over here to Raleigh and talk with her about the fund, because she wants somebody outside her inner circle to be able to know all of the things that she sees as her vision. She wants somebody to be able to know that besides all these folks that she's the closest to. I said, well, I'll look at my calendar and see, listen, I'll find a place and we'll get going. Well, Paul's on the other end of the phone, and she said, Marsha, I think you need to come pretty quick. So 2 days later, I'm in Raleigh. And Kay talks to me about the fund for a little bit, and then she closes her eyes and rests. Then she wakes up a little bit more and tells me a little bit more about the vision that she sees for the fund. And she goes back to sleep. We did that for a couple of days. I think all this time it was sort of assumed a little bit that maybe Stephanie Glantz would immediately start running the fund. And so one of the last conversations we had that night was, Marsha, you know Steph wants to coach, don't you? And I said, okay, that's awesome. I think that's great. She needs to coach. Now, I mean, Steph needs to coach. And looked at me again. The fourth time, it began to sink into me a little bit what she was saying. So all of you who know how persuasive Kay was know that I wasn't retired about 2 months later. I was good to go as that executive director. It was such an honor for me, and something that I have loved being a part of. I think the other thing that was so important to me during those last conversations was the fact that we were having it. That this fund was so important to her that some of her last strength she used to try to make sure that the vision for what she wanted to do was set, that it was there, that people knew it, that we knew what she wanted to try to accomplish. Because the morning that I went back to Lubbock was at the airport, Stephanie texted me and said that an ambulance just came and got her. And she never did leave the hospital again. So that's how much strength she was using in her very last moments to make sure that all of this took place. It's been an amazing 10 years. I'm so thrilled about all of the things that have been a part of this. It's been, as I said, a labor of love for me, and something that's been one of the greatest honors of my life to be a part of it. And I know that there are a lot of you out here that feel some of those same thoughts. Because first of all, we're raising money for such an amazing cause to try to find a cure. We've helped people that maybe needed our help and didn't have any way to get some things done. All of those have been fabulous. But on top of that, we've kept her legacy alive. And not only is it alive, but I think it's growing every single day. So I am so excited to see what the next decade brings. And I'm just so appreciative of everyone, all that they've done to make this happen tonight for our dear, dear friend, Kay Yow. Thank you.